When it comes to villains, some of them aren't so bad, just misunderstood. The best example I can think of related to this is Lady Eboshi from Princess Mononoke, but I won't nerd out about that here. Armageddroid, from the show we're actually named after, is another great example of this complex character type. Armageddroid is an antagonist seen twice in the series. He's a tall, silver-colored robot with a giant A on his chest. I'm not sure what the A stands for, though. He's a lot less advanced than most things in this universe, with old-timey-looking servers and gear mechanisms in his insides. He's programmed to destroy weapons, as in to stop conflict before it happens. He was built by Nora to put a stop to the constant alien invasions. Being built to get rid of all weapons, he succeeded in his mission to stop alien attacks. However, he grew uneasy during peace and began going after the Earth's weapons. Nora put a stop to him by tricking him, saying there was a super weapon in the Earth's core. Armed with this knowledge, he tunneled to the Earth's core and was assumed to be gone for good. After he was supposedly destroyed, Nora began work on the XJ units as an alternative way to protect humanity. But what can he do? Well, he moves via treads on his feet instead of walking. He usually uses black-colored tendrils to disarm any being of their weapons, but he can use his arms as blunt force weapons. He also has a furnace around his chest area to burn any and all weapons in. On the outside for defenses, he has some sort of shield that was able to shock Jenny so hard she was immobilized. Inside him, he also has many defensive measures to protect against anyone able to get inside, with some of these defenses being lasers, gas, and acid. In his first episode, he dug his way out from the ground after supposedly digging to the core and finding no weapon. He rampaged through the city, and Jenny tried to put a stop to him, only to get bashed, beaten, and then electrocuted by his shield. Kind of a mean thing to do to your long-lost sister. He was thought to be unstoppable, but Nora came up with a plan, and with Jenny's help, they blew him up with a bomb from the inside by making him think it was a weapon, and he was no more. Then we get his second appearance in Enclosure of Doom. The episode follows Jenny and Kilgore traveling through some sort of labyrinth, with Jenny not recalling what happened to her to get her stuck in there, but steadily regaining her memories of the events. Eventually, she remembers that Kilgore had somehow rebuilt Armageddroid and how she ended up within his body. After breaking out, she thinks about how to beat Armageddroid. She then realizes he doesn't want to destroy all weapons, but he must. She then convinces him he's a weapon, and he self-destructs. Some really weird sibling bonding going on here. Considering the circumstances, Armageddroid wouldn't come back after that, since his story was pretty much finished. I just realized how similar Armageddroid's backstory is to Ultron's. I'm not sure if he was directly inspired by Ultron, but they were both created by a scientist with good intentions, and both turned evil. The main difference between Ultron and Armageddroid is that Armageddroid is technically doing exactly what he was designed to do. He's destroying weapons. If you think about it, if he continued doing so, the Earth would be much more peaceful. Obviously, Jenny would be defeated too, but maybe that would be a good trade-off for world peace. Was Armageddroid really a bad guy? Or was he just an extremist trying to fulfill his function? Like many characters who have tunnel vision, Armageddroid was unable to see the error of his limited worldview and ultimately destroyed him in the end. He was so focused on solely fulfilling his purpose that he became the very thing he had vowed to destroy. What do you guys think of Armageddroid? Is he a bad character? Or just poorly designed by Nora? Be sure to tell us in the comments below. If you want to potentially discuss Armageddroid, other characters, and much more, consider joining the MLAATR fanbase Discord. It's the largest group of active My Life as a Teenage Robot fans on the internet. I've been your narrator, Andre. Thanks for watching.
Thanks for watching this video. If you enjoyed it, leave a rating. If you want to reach us, leave a comment. Or check out our other platforms. Links are in the description.